Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a quick look at a small but very old set. This is from 1980. It's a Legoland series or town series of set, and it was called the Bucket Loader. Now, what you see is exactly what you get. It's just that. It's a small little thing. 1980 was 2 years after they first introduced the concept of a minifig, a articulated minifig, as we all love so much today. This was just a very basic little construction tractor kind of thing, which worked really well because it fits the minifig in there. It carries some tools on the back, some stuff that the minifig can use. It's got the little light up there, which you can use to pretend that the light is actually flashing or rotating around. And you've got this working bucket. That's the best thing about it. You can kind of angle that down. You could use this if you wanted to in like a sandbox kind of arena and actually dig in. And then without even touching the bucket, use these little levers back here and lift that up. That's the best thing about this right there. You lift it up and it's able to hold on to a load just perfectly. You could use small Lego pieces in there. You could use other stuff. You can get it way up high. Whoa, out of frame. Way out up high like that. And you can take it to some place and actually dump the stuff out. So, you know, it's just really simple, but it's perfect for what it is. It's the right size to fit a minifigure in there and for younger kids to be able to play with this. It says on the box, ages 5 to 12, but it's probably perfectly fine for kids a little bit younger to play with and might be a little bit boring for kids that get up to the age of 12 to play with, but certainly for display it's still great. But I'm not going to judge on that. Let's take a look at the minifigure, because this was a pretty popular torso print that was used on a lot of different figures. This is period correct. I got this thing used off eBay, but it's got the right figure in there. It's been stored pretty nicely. I see a little bit of wear on that original head with the smaller, a little bit thinner print there. No print on the back of this, but I remember these figures back when they were still available in stores, and I especially liked these helmets. The hard hat there is really nice because it has those ridges going all the way around it. Makes it look extra realistic. And then on the back again, you've got the shovel and the little wrench. Now I mentioned something about what it looks like on the box, or what it says on the box. I actually got the box. I was very fortunate to get the box with this one. And I want to show the back of the box, because like they always did in those days, shows some optional builds using the same parts, just a different way to build a tractor there. Put the engine in the back, make it a little bit more like a skip loader. Alternately, you can make this very tough to move around, a little hand cart, actually a very large hand cart, probably not the best use of pieces, but if you had other sets, you could use some of the parts that aren't used in this with other builds. This kind of makes a little truck, more like a kind of like a dump truck. Doesn't work so well for carrying stuff, because of the holes. You have to put a full-on brick back there, but you know, it's just different ideas. And then here's yet another way that you can build up a loader. So they just gave you more ideas for things you could do even with such a small set, and that was really great. So there you go, a very small but very charming set from 1980, the Bucket Loader. I like this thing very, very much. Sometimes with the really simple stuff, you know, it was just too simple, but this one strikes a perfect balance, I think, between playability and cuteness and value. You know, it didn't cost too much back then because it had so few pieces. So thank you very much for watching this video. Feel free to share your thoughts about this set in the comment section if you would like. I do new set reviews as well as old set reviews, and I work on custom stuff, so you can follow all of my updates of stuff that I'm working on at my blog at jangbricks.com. And if you subscribe to the channel, you'll get all the notifications of new videos as soon as they're uploaded. Thanks for watching this one, and I'll be talking to you again soon.